Internet.
Thank you very much. Welcome back. Mino and the Mayor here, 97.9 FM, WGBW, 98.3 FM, WISS. And, of course, the Civic Media app. It is a beautiful morning out there, 70 in Green Bay and Appleton, 72 in Oshkosh. What's it like in Wausau, Brittany Merlot?
About the same here. Nice warm morning, cloudy, little bit of drizzle. That's going to be a day, isn't it?
How hot was it the other day, like heat index-wise, Friday? Oh.
Good question. I stayed in the AC, but it definitely hit triple digits. I did see a 100-degree heat index, at least here into Wausau. I saw 91-degree temperatures being hit all across the state. It was a scorcher, wasn't it?
And did you see on my Facebook what I did between the hours of 2 and 4?
No. What'd you do? Did you ride your bike?
Air-conditioned bar.
Walked 19,000 steps. 8.9 miles.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Actually, he did. He did. I questioned him on who was wearing his pedometer, but yeah, it. You
Ben really Malcor, who comes on our show here, he was right at the very end here. He's walking us. I go, "Hey, Ben." He goes, "Hey." I go, "Hey." He goes, "Hey." He goes, "Oh, John." Yeah. He goes, "I got to be honest with you. I didn't recognize you."
Yeah. Walking, looking, trying
so
to exercise
and worn out,
and exercising at that.
I look at the Bataan Death March. Yeah,
you know, Brittany, I looked for you at the.
But I got to tell you something, though, Jim. You'll not appreciate, but you'll be as frustrated with it. Okay, I lost 5 pounds. You know, I know, but what I got on my scale?
No, I hear you.
And then the next day, it's down to like 2, and then it's 1, and then it's like, was it worth it?
Well, yes, it was. Your metabolism is maybe changing. I will tell you. So Johnny and I, we got this Coach Kathy. You got to listen to her. She comes on every couple of weeks, or Todd's going to set that up. A lady who lives here in Green Bay, get this, Brittany. She lost 200 pounds.
Wow.
I used to work with her back in the day, and she came here. She was actually here to do something for veterans. She's got a program to help aging veterans keep their homes up. Anyway, so we talked to her about that. But when I went to the door, and I said, "You look familiar." And she goes, "You don't recognize me?" And I'm like, "No." She goes, "Well, that's because I lost 195 pounds. But you know, your eyes are like the same, right? But anyway, she did it on her own. She went to Kohl's. Not that that's part of her story. She went to Kohl's and was trying on clothes, size 24. In the dressing room, looking in the mirrors, she goes, "I'm done." Went home, threw all the bad food out. Didn't use it, just threw it out and started this program. Did a little research, and she's doing great. Great spirit, high energy.
And she was in an unbelievable bad car accident, lost a leg.
Oh, my gosh.
And so she still had the willpower to overcome that.
Prosthetic leg, and she walks like 10 miles a day, like 2-3 hours
a day. I mean, you want
to
talk about somebody inspiring, and she's like, no, like with us, she's like, no holds barred.
No, she talks
brutally honest.
We told her what our...
Yeah.
we're talking... she was
but
sitting,
our BMI.
Our BMI. We're talking about, because Todd did our BMI, you know, the weight, height thing, you know, and then your BMI is a percent of, you know, whatever, 30, 31, whatever, should be in the 20s. But, and we said, we both did our BMI, and it came to 33.6. And she looks at our guts. She goes, tighter than that.
I think it's higher.
Oh,
I mean, not even.
She's our guest. No. She was our guest.
But
so.
She literally looked down at our guts. She goes, it's higher. So she's brutal in that way. But very inspirational.
Yes.
Well, Brittany, I have to ask. We haven't talked to you since EAA. How did your entire week go?
Oh, it was a blast. It was so much fun. Everything that, did you guys get to see the car that's like flying? It's got the wheels and everything, and it's going to be able to hover above the ground, so you don't have to worry about rental cars or renting planes. It
like
blew my
Jetsons.
Mind. Yes, that's what I was thinking.
Wow.
Did it fly? Did they demo it, or was it just on the ground?
It was just on the ground. But
oh, okay. Yeah, I may have. I went to that personal aircraft area.
I wish we'd have seen that, actually.
Yeah.
That sounds pretty cool.
I don't know that I saw that.
How much further down the road do you think for that happen?
I think that you could order it right now, and you can go there and help them build it, and then by 2027, you can have this.
Wow.
I know.
Jim, come on.
Do you remember that? I might.
Your garage is clean now.
It is. I got a super clean garage. Three cars.
The garage.
I spent all weekend. Actually, Donna took off work on Friday. It was her birthday. John sang happy birthday to her, and she says thank you.
Do you
again.
Have anybody I need to sing happy birthday?
No, not today. No.
Yes, sir.
No,
yeah. Oh, we do? Okay, excellent.
Anyway, it's like my. I said, what do you want to do? You know? And she goes, I'd like to get that garage cleaned out. I'm like, what? But it's her birthday, so she took off work Friday, as did I, and I worked here. But it's, I could fit in one of those flying cars in my garage now. I could.
You can.
How much are they? Because I pulled some stuff on those personal planes for like 36, 32,000. Do you know how much price was on those?
I don't remember. A little bit too much for me. So I.
But that, if they're in the 30s, that's a steal.
That's what I thought. The plane, this is the plane.
Yeah, but
little,
still.
It was a little kit plane. It was 36,000.
Right. I mean, you can't buy a car for that.
No.
Well, you can.
Well.
But cars aren't. Well, yeah, new cars are expensive. I was, where was I?
Have you checked out trucks? No, go try to find a pickup truck. I saw one the other day, $104,000.
Yeah.
A pickup truck.
Ooh.
I said, yeah. I was, I don't know where I was. I was in an interview. I must have been interviewing somebody for my show, and we were talking about price and inflation and how expensive things are. And I'm, look, I said, you're talking to a guy that paid more for his last car than he did for his first house. You know, I mean.
Yeah, that's the way it's gotten, though.
And
I know.
Believe me, my wages haven't kept that pace.
I paid $68,000 for my first house. Yeah. How much was yours?
Oh, it was less than that. 39, okay.
39, 9. 30, wow, okay.
Yeah.
But I'll never buy a car for $68,000. I don't have Brittany's money.
Brittany. I don't even have a house yet. I want a house for that price. Man.
Did you get caught in the rain out there at all? In your tent?
Saturday?
What did you do? Yes.
That was crazy. I left. Yeah, it was, not Saturday, Sunday. It got rained out Sunday. We were watching the air show, and it rained so hard that we left on Sunday. But I was there Saturday. Saturday was all right. It was good.
Yeah, Saturday turned out pretty good. Did you get to see the night air show? Did you stay for that?
No, I gotta be up at 3:30. So no.
Why do you have to be up at 3:30?
Because that's the time I get up.
Do you though? Because you always say you come in at like 4:15, and you're not here till.
Okay, you guys
six.
Look at my texts. I send out emails to people. Always.
Oh, there's nothing I'd rather get than a text from you at 3:30 in the morning.
I'll do this
nothing
during
at
break.
All, please.
Anyway, back to you, Brittany.
Brittany, do you ever use a steamer to steam your clothes?
I used to when I would wear the dresses for TV all the time. Not so much anymore.
Right. And steamers are great. And they take up a little bit of room, but you know, but you can hang the thing. And so have you ever in your life steamed one of your dresses or clothing when you were wearing it?
No.
Nobody would. That would who would iron their clothes on when they're wearing them? You know, really going to put an iron on your gut? So John is complaining about this this burn. Oh, I got this burn. I'm like, oh man, that's too bad. How did it happen? But once he told me he did it when he was ironing his clothes while he was wearing them, all sympathy went away.
Yeah, okay, Brittany, here's the deal. So it's like the bottom of my shirt was all wrinkled, and I was going to a birthday party for a good friend of mine. And so I'm holding it out like this, and I'm steaming it, okay? And then I said, there's a little more there. So I thought it was in the, I could stand up right now and show you the burn I have on my stomach.
I think you won't do that.
No.
Thank you.
Like, you can't believe what this thing looks like. And I'm not kidding you. Yeah.
Can you believe that?
It might be permanent. This might be a permanent on my stomach now.
Finally a tattoo.
Yeah.
Finally.
Yeah. Yeah. It hurt like you can't believe. Steam is really hot.
Yeah, okay. It'll get you.
Yeah, I think it'll get you.
It is. I mean, it's crazy hot. You wouldn't think that because it doesn't seem like it is.
I mean, have we come down? Have we? You know, they always talk about the dumbing down of America. Are we that low now where we have to put on, you know, remove clothes before ironing? I mean,
well, what's her name? Maria Parmigiani last week. She had that burn from her curling iron on her forehead. So many things can happen. Yeah.
Yeah. That's a little different. You can't really take your hair out. I'm saying you can take your clothes out.
I don't think I'm the first person to ever try to steam their clothes while they're wearing them.
And Jim. I do.
I don't. So. We can do a quick poll on that for people that have steamers. I'm telling you. Other people have done that.
Speaking of steaming, it's there's no air here today, God, Brittany. It's 85 degrees in the studio, and we're just making our own gravy this morning. Yeah. Is basically what's going on.
And we're drinking coffee.
So is it going to start cooling down for us or what?
It's dark today. Todd and I both said the same thing when we came in. It's like dark out. It's like, did something change now with Soleus or whatever?
No, just the low pressure bringing in these nasty clouds that are going to hang out with us all day today. Temperatures, though, aren't going to get too steamy, so you're only going to rise about 5 more degrees there. Your studio might go another 10. So
yeah, it will.
You'll probably have a higher temperature.
But
I was talking to my brother the other day up in Michigan. They're getting a lot of that smoke from Canada. We haven't had any here yet, have we? I mean, not that I've noticed.
No, not this year.
Not too bad.
They send it 2 years ago.
I remember.
Unbelievable. And Britton, do you get weather people cover the earthquake that we had, that little tremor we had in Door County? Is that, or was that news?
We had an earthquake?
Right?
Yeah. Well, more news, but a little baby rumble there. Yeah, I didn't see too much of that. Well, do you know what the Richter scale put it at?
Yes, but I don't remember. 2.7?
2.7.
We had an earthquake in Door County? When did this happen?
And they asked you if you felt it. I don't know. Was it Friday or Thursday?
I didn't know anything about this.
So this happened on the 2nd. It was a 2.9 earthquake. 2.9. In Lake Michigan is where it was.
Ooh.
Yep.
Oh, under, okay.
Kind of northwest of Green Bay out
so in not on the land at all.
Not on land.
But they felt it, though, in Door County.
I didn't know we had earthquakes around here.
No, I don't. I think that was, yeah.
Wow. All right.
So you have to.
So, Brittany, I rode my bike again yesterday. The mayor even saw it.
I did. He didn't know it was me. He did. I said, I saw him with his bike, and I'm like, hey, Mino. And, you know, like John, because he's such a celebrity. Yeah, how you doing, man? Good to see you. You know, and it was me.
But, Brittany, I got to be honest. I can't ride it again. My butt hurts so much. It's mind-boggling. It's one of those tiny, little, narrow seats.
Yep.
And honest to God, I was suffering on the ride. I really was. Yep. I was like, it was terrible.
Are you sure you even have a seat on it?
Right.
So where do I get a real good, comfortable seat?
Oh, you can Amazon that. You can go to even like, what is it? Dick's Sporting Goods has those, the cushions and the gel and all of that jazz. And I told you about the shorts too, right? You can get some shorts that have padding in there.
I don't have the ones with the padding. I just had my biker shorts on underneath my other shorts.
Okay, well, imagine
it's actually
those.
Biker, like short biker underwear, whatever you want to call it. But but I just feel like it's, I feel more athletic wearing those.
You do, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah,
you know what? I think your butt's going to be better if you go one more time, honestly. If you just push it one more time, it's just going to vanish and you're going to be fine.
You know what I was thinking about doing though? It's a true story. I was thinking about putting some sponges in my shorts. I'm not kidding.
Pillows.
What'd you think about that? Get them kind of wet a little bit and then just put them in there so it'd be soft.
He thinks he's MacGyver, but he's just really, really cheap.
I know.
Yeah,
I'm just sure. That's what I was thinking about doing. That might work. You don't
know. It might.
All right.
Ishbaming MacGyver, though. You know what I'm saying?
Megani. That's right. So, Brittany, but what? I was looking, and you, it's really, this is your part to say, but what a great, great week we're coming up on.
Isn't it? Perfect temperatures too. Beautiful sunshine. I mean, the only crummy day is today, really, with the clouds and the chance for those rain. We are looking at some decent rain though this afternoon and evening, where we could see anywhere from 1 to 2 inches.
Wow.
So some flash flooding. Farmers not happy about that, of course. But this system is just slowly moving over us. And as it goes to the south, it actually combines with Hurricane Debby. So it's going to take its sweet time, head down to Georgia. And as it does that, it clears us out. And for the rest of the week, we just sit in those upper 70s with a lot of sunshine.
Nice.
Yeah.
That perfect.
That Debby, though, that's what? Aren't they getting like 10 inches in a couple hours? Like, that's some serious, serious rain down in Florida.
I was looking too. They were just projecting, I think, almost 20 inches into Savannah, Georgia. So heavier rain into Georgia.
20 inches.
20. That's... Yeah.
You know what one of the big problems is when that happens? And Todd, you'd know about this being from Mississippi. The water moccasins get washed out of their dens, like, so they're all just swimming around in the water there.
No.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I had a friend that worked for, what's the group that goes down when there's an emergency?
Red
Cross. Yeah. And she said the same thing, that they were always warned, like, when you're picking up debris then afterwards, it helped clean up, be real careful about what could be under that debris.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, I felt sorry for them because, you know, that's really not. Well, it is Florida, but it's more in the panhandle. But, man, are they going to get whacked today with that weather?
Florida gets nailed with everything, don't they?
They do.
Yeah.
I mean, incredible.
Yeah.
I wouldn't live there.
This
is unbelievable, this week that you're bringing us. This is where, I love the weather people, because this is.
Oh, my God. You're lying out your butt.
No, just this week. This week.
only this week.
Brittany, he's terrible to weather people. He's horrible
nice
to weather people.
I'm just glad he's nice to my face.
That's because you're more accurate. So.
Thanks, Jim.
Oh, my God.
You bat better than 500. Some of these guys don't.
Brittany, again, Jim's views, no. What's the thing, the disclaimer, Todd?
Yeah,
in no way reflect the views of
we don't agree.
Mino or Todd or anybody else with Civic Media. Brittany Merlot, great to talk to you. Great to have you on.
You too, guys. Have a
great
one.
Enjoy this
week.
Take
care.
You bet.
Thanks.
We're going to set a quick break. We got Teddy Stefaniak coming up. We got Jack Gage from Patriot Racing Project. We got a lot of great guests coming on today, folks. Stay with us.
Home for Nightlight with Peach Wabba. Cash back is not available on gas in New Jersey and Wisconsin.
Billy, your gas light's on. We need to stop and fill up.
No way, Jen. Gas around here is too expensive. We can make it a little further.
Billy, listen to your big sister.